Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. En el nombre de Allah, el benéfico, el misericordioso. In the name of Allah, the beneficent, the merciful. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his messenger. Want to greet our beautiful family here in Chicago and all across the planet, the original family of the planet Earth. I want to greet you in the greeting words of our forefathers in the ancient language of Arabic. Assalamu alaikum. How is everyone feeling? I too am fine and humbled and honored to just have a few moments with you this afternoon to share with you, since we have so many youth, and I'm a young person myself, hopefully you are too, but I wanted to share with you, especially my young black and so-called Latino brothers and sisters, whether you be a black man born in Chicago or New York, the descendants of slaves brought across in the hulls of ships from Africa, or whether you be the descendants of our original people of the Western Hemisphere, that were in Puerto Rico and in Cuba, that were in North America and in Alaska and in Mexico into Central and South America, I want to say to us as young people in particular that we must recognize today that we are one family and one people. And I want to echo all praises due to Allah. I want you to know that the man you're going to hear from today, though he's a black man born from among you, as a leader and a gift from God for you, he's our gift too. Because as we came naturally from you as original people, when you look at me with my slightly different complexion, slightly different hair texture, I want you to recognize that we are family because we are a universal people. We come in all shades and colors and we speak all languages because all of it came from the original black man of the planet Earth. All praises due to Allah. All praises due to Allah. So what do we look like today as Latin kings in New York City? As Cubans and those from different ethnic groups in Central America and the Caribbean fighting one another today? And fighting poor black people against poor so-called Latinos for the benefit of who? Who's our enemy today? Who's the one as is both under their foot today? It's not the Mexican hurting the black man. It's not the black man preventing the Mexican from having justice in Mexico, justice in Central America, a free Puerto Rico, an independent nation for the Boricua people. It's not the black man preventing that. And it's not the Latino preventing you from having justice today in this hour. The same man who robbed us of justice, the same man who robbed us of freedom, the same enemy that took our people and conquered and destroyed them, today has us fighting one another, disgracing the legacy of our God and our people. We should be ashamed today. All praises due to Allah. As young people, as so-called enlightened people, now that God has been present amongst us, that we still fall for the same trick and plan of our open enemy, looking at one another, fighting over crumbs while the master rules us both and now has us pitted one against the other. Why today? Because he has taught us that we are nothing, but we are in the presence of a man today, a living human being who embodies and carries the love of God for all of our people. So when we hear him as Mexicans and Puerto Ricans, we're not listening to a foreigner who's speaking a strange language that is not our own. We hear the spirit of God in a man, and if his skin happens to be darker than ours, and his hair happens to be curlier than ours, and his language happens to be different because of a different conqueror and slave master that he came up under, it's all right today. Because today there's a spirit present of truth, and that truth is cutting through the lies that the enemy has set up so that we can never see each other as we truly are, which is family to one another. We are the people of God, and by his grace and will today, and under the direction and guidance of a man who's been blessed to speak the language of the people. So when you see Mexicans saying, I'm with Farrakhan, don't be surprised today. Don't think that God has forgotten about you, black man and woman. No, no. It's the opposite effect today. Know that God is sending aid out of his love for you that you may recognize and take your rightful place as our head. Since we came from you, it is right that in the last hours of this dying world, you be put at the head again.
And I would ask my Mexican and Puerto Rican and Latino family, don't reject wisdom and guidance today because you don't think it's part of you. Because you hear the language black today and you see yourself as Latino or Mexican or something else. What is that? Who made you Mexicans? Who made you Puerto Ricans? Who made you and I so-called Latinos today? And who is it helping for us to keep our mentality in that condition? I want to see us change our language because we're not Mexicans. We were here before Mexico started. We're not Puerto Rico because we were here before Puerto Ricans started. We were before Cuba, before Guatemala, before Ecuador, before Chile. Who are we? We are the original people of the planet, and so are you, black man, and we love you, and we will be in unity. For the benefit of all of our people, I only want us to make sure we're under the right guidance and the right word, and you're in the right house of God today, the real house of God, the human being who is manifesting the spirit and the wisdom and the language of God for all of the people of God. I thank you for this time to have just a few moments to share, hopefully, what I've learned from the Honorable Minister Larkin for you.
We will soon make a try at converting and uniting all the originals of this Western Hemisphere, a quote from the Honorable Elijah Muhammad in a message to the black man.